Well, today's report is certainly going to be a tough pill to swallow for those who lost money, in some cases their life savings, in their dealings with FRM. The AG's report details infighting, finger pointing, and, quote, avoidance of responsibility among state agencies, including the AG's office under the watch of then Attorney General Kelly Ayotte. Tonight, Ayotte and the others in the report respond.
And it identifies significant failures in all three state agencies.
Starting with his own office, Attorney General Michael Delaney says several warning signs were missed prior to and during Kelly Ayotte's time in charge.
The Department of Justice made serious mistakes in handling the FRM matter. We missed opportunities to expose fraud.
This was not a matter that I had any personal contact with.
Wednesday, Ayotte says while she does concede there could have been better communication within her office regarding FRM, the bulk of the responsibility lies elsewhere.
The report makes clear that the agencies with primary jurisdiction here are banking and securities, and that they had information as far back as the year 2000 and failed to aggressively pursue the matter and act.
As for security's role in this, Delaney says it failed to follow up on complaints starting in 2001 and rails against allegations from outgoing securities chief Mark Connolly of a government cover-up.
I think the only thing that may be worse than a cover-up is an unsubstantiated claim of a cover-up that's designed to place blame and avoid responsibilities.
Connolly responded by saying all the facts still have not been released and that there should be an outside investigation.
The Attorney General's office is not a disinterested party to this proceeding.
As for the Banking Commission, Delaney says it failed to act on several examinations that showed, quote, significant and repeated violations of state and federal law. In another twist, a banking commissioner, Peter Hildreth, recused himself from the case several years ago because his brother was an investor at FRM. But he does admit he may have accidentally participated in the investigation through memos and verbal advice.
I shouldn't have done those, but I believe that at the time it never occurred to me that this was that company or whatever, because I have no memory of it.
All right, so following the AG's report, Governor Lynch responded by saying that it's clear the state agencies failed in one way or another. He has also pledged that they will be held accountable, but in what fashion remains to be seen. Now, on Friday, more documents related to the state's response to the matter are expected to be made public. On that very same day, a legislative panel will meet to find ways to try to keep something like this from ever happening again. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.